This is Lou LaVolpe with Film School Online. Today we're going to talk about video standards and formats, including high definition, ultra high definition, progressive and interlaced scanning, and 24p. These are all new terms that have hit the market in the last couple of years. Most students understand that this is great new video, but they're not clear on exactly what's going on inside the camera. The concepts are surprisingly easy to understand, but we're going to have to start from the beginning, how the image is recorded, and build on that. The video image is recorded on magnetic tape stock, and the tape stock travels over a recording head called a recording drum because it spins around. The drum is actually an electromagnet, and as the tape travels over the drum head, it magnetizes the tape based on the signal coming from the image processor. The signal that is recorded to videotape is essentially the video image. On the newer cameras, you could record to hard drive or removable card, similar to the way you do it on a computer. The card is convenient because it allows you to take the card out of the camera and pop it into a computer for immediate editing. Now, the difference between a video and a film image is that the film image is recorded as one image chemically onto a piece of film, which is plastic coated with various chemicals, various layers. In video, the image is recorded one line at a time, one horizontal line at a time, similar to the way you write a paragraph. It starts at the upper left-hand corner of the frame and travels downward towards the lower right-hand corner. These lines are called scan lines. And if you look at a television, if you go real close to the screen, you'll see the lines. You could see the different lines that make up the image. That's the standard for all video images, is that they're recorded one horizontal line at a time, called scan lines. The more scan lines that a video frame has, the greater the detail is in that video image. This is known as definition. You've heard the terms standard definition and high definition before, standard def and high def. The difference between standard def and high def is that high definition has more scan lines. That's why there's more detail. In standard definition video, which is the typical video that you see on a television screen, the image is made up of 525 lines. This standard is used in the United States and Japan, and it's known as NTSC. In most European countries, the standard is 625 lines, and it's known as PAL. When you hear the term standard definition, that's what it means. 525 lines, United States, and 625 lines, Europe. Before we get into the next concept of progressive versus interlaced scanning, let's talk a little bit about the video versus film look. The reason that film has that look, which is a fluid, natural feel to motion, is that film has a relatively slow frame rate of 24 frames per second. 24 frames per second results in a slight blur to motion. If you look at each frame separately, you'll see that there's a little bit of blur when an object or a person is moving across the screen, or let's say somebody swings their arm. You can see slight blur in each different frame, and that gives film that fluid look.
We hope that you enjoyed this preview. The entire podcast lecture series is available at Film School Online, www.filmschoolonline.com. In addition, there are sample lessons, free tutorials, tips, resources, and of course, our online filmmaking courses. Thanks for listening.